It's something we don't often think about, but a living will or advance directive is an important document that will speak for you when you cannot speak for yourself. Joining us now is Dan Mikus, administrator at Angelic Palliative and Hospice Care, which serves the South Jersey community. So first of all, what is a living will and what should we have in it?
Living will is the same thing as an advance directive, and what it does is it expresses what your desires are when you can't speak for yourself. Maybe you have a serious illness, or you've become so ill that you can't make those decisions for yourself. It lets your family know or your providers know exactly what care you want.
What are some of the items that you should include in that? Should you select someone to make decisions for you?
Yes, actually, selecting someone that you know is going to carry out your wishes, that's probably one of the most important things. The second thing is to have the discussion with your physician so you understand exactly what you're asking for in your advance directive. So when you have an advance directive, you want to spell out whether or not you want those nutritional feedings, whether or not you would want to be on a ventilator, how long you would want to be on a ventilator. Those things that would help your caregivers and your family understand what your wishes are better.
It really is something that you give to your loved ones to help them to make decisions if it should ever happen. It's kind of a labor of love.
It's that peace of mind that they have. And it's also important to talk about your advance directive with your family members before it ever gets to that point, so they understand what's written is really what you want.
And of course, talk about hospice and palliative care as well. All right, thank you so much. Very good information, something to think about. Dan Mikus of Angelic Palliative and Hospice Care, serving the South Jersey community. And you're living well. I'm Robin Stoloff.